Hi everyone, welcome to the PrestaShop 1.7 tutorial video series. Today we'll be covering PrestaShop 1.7, which is the newest version of the PrestaShop software. I'm going to show you how to install it. It is very easy to install. Once all the files are on your web server, you should be able to start configuring your shop in no less than 5 minutes in most cases. The installation process is very simple, as the installer takes care of everything for you. Before you get started, make sure you have all the requirements available. Server space at a hosting provider, domain name, FTP client, text editor. Make sure to follow the instructions in the What You Need to Get Started page first. Our official web hosting partner, 1&1, offer a one-click install in order to save you time and get you started even faster. Using these can drastically reduce the installation time for inexperienced users. Step 1. Downloading the PrestaShop archive. First, download the latest version of PrestaShop at www.prestashop.com. Click on the download link at the top of the homepage. On this page, you can download the latest version of PrestaShop or the previous one, the 1.6 version. Today, we are going to download the latest one, so click on Start Now, then indicate your email address, what describes your situation the best, and your native language. Click on the download button and save the archive on your computer. You should get a file named PrestaShop with the version .zip. Step 2, unzipping the PrestaShop archive. The downloaded file is a zip archive. In order to continue with the process, you must uncompress the archive. If your operating system does not natively support zip files, you can download and install a dedicated tool, such as 7-zip or WinZip for example, which are both free to use. The zip file archive has three items at its root. The PrestaShop.zip, which contains all the PrestaShop files that you will soon be uploading on your web server. The installprestashop.html file, which opens the Getting Starter guide in your default browser. And the index.php file, which launches the installation. Using a zip tool, extract the content of the archive to a known location on your hard drive, but don't upload the zip file directly to your web server. Step 3. Uploading PrestaShop. First, make sure that you have a hosting space. We will be working from a folder on your hard drive with the uncompressed PrestaShop archive. This step makes you upload the two unzipped PrestaShop files on your hosting space. This is done by connecting your computer to your server using a tool known as an FTP client. We will be using the free FileZilla. Download the FileZilla client, not the FileZilla server. Connect to your hosting space using your FTP client by using the connection details provided by your web host. Once connected, it is time to transfer the PrestaShop files from your computer to your server. Within FileZilla, browse your local folders until you find the one that contains the two unzipped PrestaShop files. Keep it open in the Local Site section on the left. In the Remote Site section, browse to the location where you want PrestaShop to be publicly available. It can be at the root or in a subfolder. On FileZilla's left side, you should now have the local folder where you keep the PrestaShop files from the zip archive, and on the right side, the destination location. Select the three files from the local folder and drag and drop them to the remote folder. Step 4. Creating a database for your shop. Before you can actually install PrestaShop, you need to make sure that your MySQL server has a database ready for PrestaShop's data. If not, you must create one. Creating a database can be done using any database administration tool. Most hosts let you use the PHP MyAdmin tool. Some hosts prefer to have customers use a graphic control panel, such as cPanel, Plesk, or a custom-made one. Make sure you read your host's documentation about handling MySQL databases and create a database for your shop by following their specific explanations. By following your host's instructions, you should be able to create your own database if there's not already a default one. Step 5. Launching the auto installer. Now we are going to install PrestaShop. The installation process is quite easy, as it is streamlined by PrestaShop's auto installer. You should be able to browse through it in a handful of minutes. So, to launch the installer, simply browse to PrestaShop's location on your web server. The script will unzip the PrestaShop.zip file that you have uploaded. Once the unzipping is done, you will be redirected to the auto installer, which will automatically detect that PrestaShop is not yet installed, and will start the installation process. From there on, you just have to read, click, and fill a few forms. There are 6 steps. At the top of the page, the installation assistant gives you a visualization where you are in the process. First, select the language in which you wish the installer to be, and then click the next button. The second page is a simple requirement. PrestaShop is free and distributed under a certain set of open source licenses. You simply cannot use this software if you disagree with the terms of the licenses, and this step requires that you explicitly acknowledge them. You must agree to both licenses in order to install PrestaShop, then click Next. The third page makes a quick check of all the server parameters on your host, PHP settings, permissions on files and folders, third-party tools, etc. If anything goes wrong, the installer stops here, enabling you to see the few technical details that need fixing, be it changing the PHP configuration or updating the file permissions. You could find a list of the checks that are performed during this third step in the 1.7 documentation. In many cases, getting the indicators to green only requires a bit of technicity from you or a friend. Sometimes it might require you to contact your web host. Don't hesitate to ask for help. Once all the indicators are green, you can click Next. Here you will have to add your store information. This is where you can start customizing your shop, give it a name, indicate its main activity, and indicate the personal information for the shop owner. This is also where you choose the password to log into the administration panel of your shop. Choose wisely so that you will remember it, but make sure it is secure too. Click Next to continue. Here is the last installation step. The page contains a form that enables you to tell PrestaShop where the database server is and which database it should use, along with a few other details. All this information should have been provided to you by your web host. First, the database server address. This is the host name of your MySQL server. It can be tied to your domain name, or tied to your web host, or simply be an IP address. The database name. It's the name of the database where you want PrestaShop to store its data. This is either an existing database on your MySQL server, or the one that you created using PHP MyAdmin. The database login. The name of the MySQL user that has access to your database. The database password. Tables prefix. The prefix for your database tables, PS, is the default, resulting in your PrestaShop SQL tables having names such as PS cart or PS customer. But if you need to install more than one instance of PrestaShop on the same database, then you must use a different prefix for each installation. Click Next. The install will start configuring your shop, creating and populating the database tables, etc. This might take a few minutes, so please be patient and do not touch your browser. Your shop is now installed and ready to be configured. Step 6, completing the installation. Before leaving the installer, you have to delete some key files and folders to improve your installation security. This is done using your FTP client directly on the server. The items to delete are, imperatively, the install folder, and optional, the docs folder, and the readme file. Another way to secure your installation is to use a custom name for the administration folder. Change the admin folder for something unique to you, such as 4dmin1537. Write down the new name for your new admin folder, because from now on you will access your administration pages using this address. Now you can click on the Manage Your Store button in order to be taken to your administration area. Congratulations, installation is now complete. You can log into the PrestaShop back office by going to your newly renamed admin folder and start filling your catalog with products, adding carriers and shipping costs, adding brands and suppliers, and so launching your online store. Thanks for watching this PrestaShop tutorial video, and see you for the next one.